Welcome everyone, Dr. Thor here, and welcome to Gnosis. Let's talk about the great scientists and all those people with the big degrees that society tends to walk behind and idolize. The great egomaniac scientists. Now, the plain and simple fact is that since science has completely failed society in every single level, of course, you still want to follow these boobs. Like the boobs who follow non-fighters like Bruce Lee and want to say he's the greatest fighter when he never even hit himself. So the whole idea is that this is nonsense. You're living in an urban myth as usual. Everything you know and believe is an urban myth, filled by the idiot teachers that you follow, the bogus books they teach from, and you can't get anything stupider than a so-called educated, or what we really should say is PhD, brainwashed. Three initials that mean brainwashed. And for some reason, these people are idolized. Yet they really have done absolutely nothing, and they don't function in the world very well. Quite frankly, if you were in any kind of society situation where you want to get something done, do you really need a computer programmer or the worst scum on the earth, an engineer? Boy, you're going to be in trouble. Now, I'd prefer to be with a guy who knows how to build something, who's a carpenter, who's a plumber or something else. These are things that we all need in life and are very important for our functioning. We don't need these people that are giving us zero answers. We have to stop supporting failure. And that's what we've done forever. Science is supposed to do something for us. Like what? Well, let's take medical science. There's been no breakthroughs in medical science since antibiotics, particularly penicillin, which was in the late 40s. After that, nothing. It's a corrupt sewer of pseudo-intellectuals who are robbing you every day, and that's okay for you. People are dying because they can't get drugs that were even supposed to be free. By the inventors of 100 years ago, like adrenaline, I should say, I'm sorry, insulin, which they've ran the prices up of something that the inventors wanted to be given to the public at no cost. And they keep gouging you, and these old drugs that are over 100 years old are now robbing people with no new answers. We do know that all the new drugs coming out are very toxic, and there's a death rate to everything that comes out. That's a complete, total fraud. No answers, no solutions, no nothing. The entire medical industry is an entire fraud. But let's go through some things they have. These great PhDs, these medical doctors of what they've cured. Let's go through their list. Acne.
No.
Dandruff.
No.
Tinnitus.
Oh, no.
We go on and on with these really stooges that should be basically stoned every time they go out on the streets. Why should we respect them? Do we have any products that really work worth a damn? Well, not really. We can thank the engineers for that, that build the garbage-ish junk you could possibly have. And I've known lots of them. My father was an engineer, one of the stupidest men on the planet, and his friends were even stupider than he was. He couldn't fix his car. He couldn't do anything. He made crappy money. He was a loser, like all the engineers that he knew that knew nothing and produced nothing, as they continue to do today. So we can thank them. We can thank the failure of every single society structure, from government to the military to law enforcement, if you can un-law enforcement, because all they do is work for criminals, as we go on and on with it. So scientists are nothing but egomaniacs beating a dead horse that produces absolutely nothing. They have put a system together that stops the progression of anything valuable. Now, every scientist will tell you the way that science evolves is through the death of every scientist. So while these scientists who have predetermined ideas based on their fictional reality, because they live in an urban legend too, most scientists believe in the little man in the sky that doesn't exist and all the other bogus Newtonian understandings of life, the chemical makeup of life, which has now been proven to be completely and totally fraudulent, that everything is based on a quantum energy field, which then builds physical matter. Now, we've known this for a long time. even such conservatives, or I don't know if you could call them conservatives, Einstein, stated that you were a fool to get into science because everybody will jump on you if you have a new idea, and it's best to become a good shoe salesman. He has stated this. So, a guy who was very dogmatic in his own things. But what people don't understand is the scientific reality is simple. You're constantly fighting for bogus money based on whatever the corporations tell you to do. And it doesn't matter what you break through with or not. You're being paid to do that. And all colleges are paid off and owned by corporations. They do research that the corporations want. And to a certain understanding, well, I get that. They're paying for it. They, you know, that's what they actually need to get their money for. They're paying for it. But there isn't any research going on that is not controlled in some fashion. So you run into the fact that that's how it is. Scientists, of course, want to be the biggest egomaniacs in the world, and I guess they want to get back at their dysfunctional youth they were persecuted or whatever as nerds. Of course, they're very well taken care of. And the other thing is that somehow college professors and scientists don't make a lot of money, perpetrated by garbage TV shows like The Big Doinkhead, The Big Bang Show, where they have to live in an apartment somewhere while they're all working at California Technology Institute. It's a joke. They're making a fortune, these people. They make hundreds of thousands of dollars a year doing pretty easy type work, certainly not stressing, and work that usually doesn't get anywhere, but they're paid for it anyway, living in the false academia, which is a bogus world to begin with. But it's perpetrated that they have to live together in an apartment and they have to buy products together because they can't afford it. I mean, this kind of nonsense is further perpetrated of complete and total lies. So here we go again with bogus understandings of all these things. So as we go into these frauds and egotistical maniacs that want to name everything after themselves, and then they claim to be experts in everything. Neil deGrasse Tyson, he thinks he knows everything. I'm going to tell you about time travel. This guy is an astrophysicist. He looks at dots in the sky and says, I think that's made of metal. So he's going to tell me all the other physics stuff because he took a class in that 25 years ago and passed because he regurgitated the garbage in there. And it's also interesting that we live in Newtonian physics. Well, Newton was an interesting guy. Not only was he celibate, living in the school system based back then, which was based on basically Catholic priest-type teaching, where all colleges really came from, whether people liked that or not. So he was probably was a homosexual, as because he was not allowed to get married or anything else, so we just don't know. But he was a great alchemist and wrote a bunch of books on religion. So here we get a very confused guy who believes in all basically quantum physics, which is what alchemy is all about. And was highly religious being in that. So, whoa, man, are you a confused dude? So the whole idea is that we've got some serious problems there. But all they did was the dumb bunkers and idiot skeptics take a tiny bit of this guy's understanding of the world, which is basically kind of a raw chemical understanding of life. Add this and that and so forth. So while these things form a very pseudo foundation for everything, it really does not solve our problems because now we're going head-to-head with these pseudo-understandings of science, which is actually hurting us instead of moving ahead in the quantum physics understanding of reality, which is basically energy fields that make everything, not chemical compounds. So it's very important to understand. What do? So they fight for all these things. They fight among each other, trying to steal each other's information so they can publish papers and get something named after themselves because they want to name everything. It's interesting how the Hubble telescope, that's not a type of telescope, that was named after Hubble, a man. So Is that right? Did he invent the telescope? Why don't we go back to the inventor of the telescope? And why do we have to call a space telescope a Hubble? Why does he get the credit? Because he was one of tens of thousands, possibly hundreds of thousands, that worked on telescope technologies, particularly all the things to get it up into space. What about Frank Monkeyhead? Why don't we call it after him? He worked on the telescope too. Got it into space, got it up there. He's the guy who built the stuff, who put the screws down on the telescope to get it up there. So the point is that all this stuff, and by the way, NASA messed up on that as well. They had to change mirrors and everything else. So it should be the non-working Hubble until they fixed it. But I guess that's what happens when you have an entire organization based on a Nazi who murdered 15,000 people. So the whole idea is that when you have all these things put together in these hysterical, freaky idiots that are called scientists, these advanced degree people who spent all their life in a lab, not really relating to anything but quasi-information again, things have now been proven to be totally worthless. Well, that's why we don't have any breakthroughs. And when somebody breaks through all that and decides to say, hey, I found something different, they tell you, shut up and sit in the corner. And if you stand up, they will knock you down and destroy your life. They will take everything you own away from you, etc. That's the system. That's the medical system. That's the legal system. That's the military system. That's how it works. And you support it. Until people get out there and stop supporting failure and losers, we're never going to get anywhere. And it certainly isn't science. Have they figured out good, clean energy? No. Have they figured out any way to cure you of even simple diseases? No. Why should we support any of these people? They should be shunned. We don't need them. We might as well go back to dancing in the woods naked and praying to spirit gods, because you'll get a lot better results there. And you know something? There's a lot of scientific evidence that that kind of stuff works over taking some pill that kills you. Until next time.